For trivial health problems like pain, common cold, and so on, it's not advisable to have medicines unnecessarily. But many a time, doctors encounter patients requesting medicines for such trivial problems. So once, a smart doctor just gave some sugar pills as medicine to them. And surprisingly, the patients reported feeling better after consuming the pills. So what miraculous power did these sugar pills have? Let's find out. This effect was because of a psychological phenomenon called the placebo effect. What does it mean? Here, the patients were given sugar pills, but they thought that they were actually receiving real medicines. So they had a positive mindset that since they had taken medicine, they would feel better. And this led to a positive effect on their health. This is the placebo effect. Now let's see another interesting example. Some runners in a race were told that they were given super oxygenated water while it was just plain water. But surprisingly, these runners ran much faster than usual. This led to the runners' positive mindset and they outdid themselves. Pretty intriguing, right? In the first example that we saw, sugar pills did the trick, while in the second, it was the water. They are called placebos. So can you think of the applications of a placebo effect? Give it a shot. Placebo effect plays an important role in the medicinal field. It's used to test the effectiveness of a new drug. Let's say there's an organization which has come up with a new painkiller and wants to check its effectiveness. Some of the volunteers in a research trial are given a placebo, while the others the actual medicines. Now, if the volunteers taking the actual drug demonstrated a significant improvement over those taking the placebo, then it means the drug is effective and we can use it as medicine. In this way, it can be figured out if the new drug actually has any effect or if it's just another placebo. We saw that a placebo can be any substance that does not have any direct effect, but it's used to change someone's mindset. Now let's see one interesting example where we don't even have to use a physical substance as a placebo. Normally, a 30-minute exercise every day is enough for a human to lead a healthy life. This is easy for people whose work involves physical activities like housekeeping. But according to the study, it has been seen that many housekeepers do not perceive their job as an exercise. So, one interesting experiment was conducted with female housekeepers. The women were grouped in two. Group 1 was given a presentation where it was told that the activities they indulge in at work are actually good exercises. And the other group wasn't given this piece of information. After a few weeks to see the result of the presentation, these women were tested on a few parameters. Surprisingly, the women from Group 1 showed quite a drop in body fat, blood pressure, and were healthier. But the ones from Group 2 didn't show any significant changes. So what do you think happened here? This example takes us to a conclusion that placebo need not be any physical substance. It can be anything that our mind believes in, even if it's just a thought. Now here, just the thought that they were receiving a good amount of exercise while they worked changed their mindsets towards their job. And this resulted in a positive change in their health. Interesting, isn't it? We now know that having the right mindset matters. Mindset affects our performances and abilities. Now, we all have a common notion that some of our abilities are innate. For example, many of us think that people are either born intelligent or they are not. We believe that the great scientists were born intelligent. So is intelligence an innate ability? Instead of having this fixed mindset, can we improve our intelligence by changing our mindset? This is your cue box to explore. Share your findings in the comments section. And if this video has succeeded in changing your mindset, Then do not forget to share this video and do subscribe to our channel.